Hello, this is Minister Edward J. Robin Belanger here on November 18th, 2010, and this is a private message to Adam Halliday. Adam Halliday, you as a private man also act as a federal prosecutor for the Government of Canada, Minister of Justice, Minister of Health for the Controlled Drugs and Substances Act. This notice to you privately is to bring you to an acute awareness of the fact that I don't consent to you nor give permission to you to intimidate me to violate my Christian faith and beliefs. It's also to inform you that the Christian monarch that this country puts up as the head of state, she's not the de facto head of state that the Governor General is, she is the head of state, Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth II, Elizabeth Alexandra Mary Windsor, and she is the lady that you took an oath to. You took an oath when you became a federal crown prosecutor. If you took that oath in Alberta, it's an invalid oath. This is notice to you that you have a fraudulent oath on the records. This is notice to you that I cannot accept any of your offers based upon that fraud because you would be attempting to intimidate me to associate myself with the fraud. This is notice to you that the province of Alberta has written false oaths since 1955 into all of its legislation. All of the men and women that act as lawyers, as crown prosecutors and judges in the province, and indeed many of the officers under the province's authority, have been taken the false oath of allegiance that is contained within the Alberta Oath of Office Act. This is in direct contravention of the Federal Oaths of Allegiance Act, Schedule 5 of the British North American Act, Sections 10 and 11 of the Governor General's Act in 1947, Section 22 of the Westminster Confession of Faith, an Act of Parliament of 1648, a direct violation of Her Majesty's ability to defend the faith and beliefs if the men and women that she counts on to be true allegiance have committed perjury by taking their oath to her, and taking one, an invalid oath, and having no intent or even knowledge of what true allegiance means, and nor intent to provide it. If you do not intend to provide true allegiance to the Christian monarch who is sworn to be defender of the faith, and that indeed is her title contained in the Royal Style and Titles Act, which you may find on Justice Canada's website, well then you are engaged in a massive fraud by implying that you have gained your authority by a Christian monarch giving you that authority to effect justice and honor throughout the realm, when you have no intent on using the Bible, respecting the Bible, or God's laws in one iota. As a matter of fact, you have intent on telling the judge that man that acts as a judge in the court cases, and that you have been witness to do, that I have no respect for the laws and believe that the laws don't apply to me. I have respect for laws, God's laws. I believe God's laws apply to me. I believe the Queen, who is your master, your head in charge, she also believes that because she defends them with all of her power. What a massive bait and switch program we have, where you've used the Bible and a Christian monarch sworn as defender of the faith to somehow gain authority so you can dictate to me some laws that have been added to God's law and taken away from God's law in violation of Deuteronomy 4 and 2, 1232, Acts 5:29, Leviticus 18, 3 through 4, Colossians chapter 2, starting in verses 14 all the way to verses 23. We're not to submit ourselves to the laws or ordinances of men or heathens. Heathens are those men that add to God's law and take away from God's law in violation of his commands to not do so. These are heathens. If we subject ourselves to these heathen laws, we have violated the commands of God. The very first one, don't bow yourself down to false gods. Don't serve them. This is very clear. That's the first commandment of God. So Adam Halliday, if you intend to intimidate me by telling me that I have to obey the orders of a false oath judge when I sign those under threat, duress, and intimidation and an examination of that document I signed that was believed to be a commercial contract, we'll see the letters U.D.I. in front of them, or by my autograph, you will see those letters. That means under duress and intimidation, and the reason I did that is I was intimidated at the Fort Saskatchewan facility when I was told I had to sign those, telling me if I put the truth on that document, telling them that I was under threat, duress, and intimidation, that if I told the truth, they would not let me out. I still told the truth. I put UDI, it's well known in financial circles, that means under duress and intimidation. I did not consent to those judges' orders because he's a false oath impostor, as are you. This is not speculation. You can refer to the Federal Oaths of Allegiance Act as many times as you wish. You can refer to the Interpretation Act, what the meaning of the word shall means. Shall be in the following form and no other is what a child of grade 2 could understand that that means it's got to be in that form and no other form. It's clear the oath you've taken is not in that form. It's clear that Alberta, as a corporation trading on the stock exchange, has, in violation of God's laws, added to his law and taken away from his law. I am giving you here formal notice and demand notice that you provide proof that you can intimidate me to avoid my lawful excuse of not submitting myself to a false God and its codes, rules, and regulations, and not submitting myself to false oath impostors. That is my lawful excuse for not appearing in front of your charade and your fraud and participating in your fraud by submitting myself to it. If you look up the word appearance in Black's Law Dictionary, you will see it means the formal process by which one submits themselves to the authority of another, or the court, submits himself to the jurisdiction of the court. Excuse me, I stand corrected. What that means is that if I show up without giving you my lawful excuse, that it's assumed that I've submitted myself to a false God. I violated the first commandment of God. I don't get to use the Bible anymore. I show disregard for God's law by showing up. So my lawful and sincere reason for not showing up, my lawful excuse for not appearing in those false fraud courts, is that they are false, they are frauds, and I cannot be compelled to correspond with a fraud, and neither can I be compelled to violate the laws of God. If you've got authority to supersede my faith and beliefs, I demand that you show me that authority and produce it. Otherwise, within 5 days' time, you'll be getting notice of an agreement with other witnesses confirming that I have an agreement with you, that you have no authority to intimidate me, to supersede the laws of God, to violate the laws of God, to derogate the laws of God, to add to the laws of God, and that I will not be appearing in your court proceedings. I will be notifying the commissioner for the RCMP. I will be notifying Heather, Minister of Justice here in Alberta, Alison Redford. Heather Klimchuk has already been notified, but I will notify Alison Redford again to bring her into awareness. I have an agreement with you. I'm also going to be forwarding this agreement to Fran Salindas. Fran Salindas is the corrections worker that has been intimidating me to show up in her offices when I've made it very clear to her it's a violation of my religious beliefs and asked her to produce proof that she had authority to do so. I attended her offices on the 12th of this month with a witness, Catherine Flamand, who has an agreement with Alison Redford with regards to travel in this province without commercial registry that has been working well so far, thank you. And Catherine did witness the intimidation that Fran Salindas did exercise upon me. That intimidation was not accepted and she was notified. So this is notification to you that you are both in awareness that intimidation has been taking place, a violation of 176, 180, and 423 of the Criminal Code. I know you feel you're immune from the law and you're above the law because the various lawyers that you have above you in association with the Federal and Provincial Department of Justices realize this is a matter of money. They don't care about respecting the law. They care about protecting their financial profits. So I thank you so much for your time, and I look forward to any reason that you would have that would denigrate or put to bed my lawful excuse for failure to appear. I've given you my lawful excuse for failure to appear. I'm going to publicize this in 5 days' time to more people. So take note, this is a serious message to you, and I hope you respect it. I hope to either hear from you or, in tacit consent, gain your agreement. May God bless. Thank you, Adam Halliday.